and welcome to another episode of Storybook Railroad. Isn't this so exciting? I've been wanting to see this movie for a really long time. Look at all these people here. Gosh, it sure is popular. No. This seat is taken. I'm sorry, but my friend is going to be sitting there. And speaking of my friend, I wonder where the giant... No. This seat is taken. Yeah, he'll be here in a moment. Ooh, I got a text. Okay, let's see what it says. Oh, okay, so the giant is standing in line for popcorn, of course. Well, that's all right. He's not going to miss anything because the coming attractions are just... No, I'm sorry, but the seat here is taken for my friend. Gosh. Wow, I wish he'd hurry up because, gosh, I can't hold on to this seat forever. The theater is packed. Well, let me watch these coming attractions.
Excuse me. Robin, oh my God, excuse me, sir. Oh my gosh, this place is packed.
I know, and I saved you this seat. Some people were wanting to sit here, but I saved it for you.
Hey, would you hold this popcorn?
Oh, wow, look at the size of this popcorn.
Oh yeah, I always like the extra large.
Oh yeah, with a lot of butter, I can see that on my fingers.
Hey, I got you some jujubes too. You like these things?
Oh yeah, I do, I love those. I love the colors, especially the green ones.
And some baby mints, what do you call these?
Oh, I love those mints. They are so good too. Well, thank you so much.
That's a big soda too.
Yeah. Oh, soda. Look at that. Wait a minute, I hear something.
Oh, that's Billy. He's under my shirt.
Billy? You smuggled Billy in the theater?
Robin, come on. This is a movie for him.
How do you mean?
Well, because we wanted to go back in time and see this old movie, right?
Right, exactly.
It's called The Birds, and I thought he might like it.
I don't know. I think he's going to spend more time in your shirt than out of your shirt. I hear it's pretty scary.
Billy, it's a scary movie. I didn't know it was a scary movie.
Well, we'll just have to, you know, feed him some popcorn or something to get his mind off of watching the screen.
It just goes to show you can't decide what a movie's about by the title. The Birds. I figured it was about a day in the park.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
Oh, it's a scary movie?
Yeah, it is. Not all of it is scary. But I think it'll be fine for a while for Billy. As long as we keep him, you know, fed with popcorn and a little bit of soda here and there, he'll be fine.
Oh, I got you these snow caps, too. You like snow caps?
Oh, I love those. I love snow caps. They are so good.
We have so much junk food today.
I know, but that's the best if we're going to watch a movie.
The movie's starting. Oh,
there it is. Here it comes.
Look at this, a coming attraction for a story you wrote.
Oh, yeah.
why don't we tell that story while we're waiting for the movie to start?
Okay, and that story is Aunt Tilda and Me.
Aunt Tilda and Me, yep. By Robin MacBlane.
Give me back my truck, Jason yelled as he tried to pry the toy vehicle out of his brother's hand. No, Cedric yelled back as he held on tighter to the truck. Give it back, yelled Jason again. This time, Jason pushed his brother to the ground. They started wrestling, all the while yelling at each other.
Hey, what's going on here? They heard a familiar voice loudly say. Two large hands seemed to appear out of nowhere, pulling apart the two wrestling boys.
Cedric started it, Jason said in a notch lower than a yell. He wouldn't give me back my truck. Jason wasn't playing with it, retorted Cedric. Mom says you can play with anything you want as long as someone else isn't playing with it first. Well, I was going to play with it, said Jason. I had it next to me. No, you didn't, Cedric began yelling again. It was way over there. Cedric pointed with his outstretched hand to a place on the other side of the room. Was not, yelled Jason back. Was too, yelled Cedric.
Boys, calm down, said their grandfather as he sat down on the floor in between them. The time you have to be together is too short as it is. You shouldn't waste it by needless arguing.
Jason and Cedric looked at their grandfather and then at each other. Jason spoke first. I'm sorry, Cedric. I guess I just wanted the truck because you had it. And I'm sorry, too, said Cedric. I just don't like to share sometimes. You sure were lucky, grandfather, Cedric said as he looked at his grandfather.
I don't understand, their grandfather replied gently and a little confused. He couldn't understand what Cedric was talking about.
Jason responded. I think he means that you were lucky. because you could play with all the toys you wanted to when you were little and not have to share them with anyone.
The twins' grandfather put one of his hands on the toy truck and rolled it back and forth across the floor. A look of sadness appeared on his face. And then, slowly, his lips formed a smile. The twins' grandfather laughed out loud.
What's so funny, Grandfather? Cedric asked. Yeah, what's so funny? Echoed Jason.
Boys, said their grandfather in amusement, have I ever told you about Aunt Tilda and me?
Jason and Cedric looked at each other and laughed. Was she the fat lady in the circus? Jason asked.
No, that wasn't her, their grandfather said. He was amused by that thought, too, though. No, boys, Aunt Tilda was the wonderful lady who showed me how precious time is and how it should not be wasted by needless arguing.
Tell us about her, Grandfather, said Jason. Was she pretty? Asked Cedric.
The curiosity of both boys was piqued. Their grandfather, Brian, leaned back against the side of one of the beds. His smile grew wider as the image of Aunt Tilda danced around in his mind.
Brian was 8 years old, and he was somewhat a happy child. He had everything one could hope for: a nice house, a pet cat, and two loving parents. And then it happened. His world was shattered in one fleeting moment.
Brian was waiting at school for his mother and father to pick him up. They would be leaving on vacation, and they needed to finish a few things before they could leave on their trip.
Well, Brian waited patiently on the front steps of the school. Pretty soon, all the other children were picked up, and Brian was left standing alone by the crosswalk. Just then, Mr. Jenkins, the principal, approached Brian.
Brian, Mr. Jenkins said, I need you to come with me. Mr. Jenkins took Brian into the school and led him into the office. There, waiting, was a lady Brian had never seen before.
The lady smiled a warm smile and said, Hello, Brian. I'm your Aunt Tilda, and I need to talk to you.
Brian stared at the huge house as he slowly got out of the limousine. Wow, he said out loud in awe.
Pretty classy, huh? He heard his Aunt Tilda say cheerily. He looked up at her, tears forming in his eyes. Aunt Tilda took his hand and led him up the front steps.
Just as they reached the top of the steps, the front door opened. A man held it open for them as they passed through. He smiled at Brian and bowed towards Aunt Tilda. Aunt Tilda let out a big laugh and tapped the man on the shoulder.
Sven, Tilda said, stop that. You don't want Brian to think we're stuffy, do you?
No, ma'am, said Sven politely as he held out his right hand for Brian to shake. Brian held tightly onto Aunt Tilda's hand.
Brian, this is Sven, said Aunt Tilda. If there is anything you need, anything at all, and you can't find me, Sven is the person to ask. He takes care of the place for me.
Brian slowly held out his right hand, and the man and the boy shook hands. Then Sven gave Brian a high five and said, Glad to have you aboard, Brian.
Come on, Brian, let me show you to your room. Aunt Tilda led Brian through what appeared to him to be a huge dance floor and up a winding staircase. They walked to the end of the hall and stopped before a huge door. On the door was a brass plate with the word Brian engraved on it.
Hey, that's my name, exclaimed Brian excitedly.
It sure is, Brian, replied Aunt Tilda lovingly. There are so many rooms here that I don't want you to forget what room is yours. Let's go inside and see if you like it.
Aunt Tilda opened the door and they entered the room. It was a very cheery room with model airplanes suspended from the ceiling. There were pictures of famous sports figures hanging on the wall. There were cartoon characters on the bedspread. Gosh, Aunt Tilda, this is great, exclaimed Brian excitedly.
Well, I didn't know what you like, so I got you a little bit of everything, Aunt Tilda said cheerily. Sven picked out the planes.
I used to build airplanes with my dad, Brian said sadly. He couldn't hold back the tears anymore. Aunt Tilda took Brian in her arms and gave him a big hug.
You know, Brian, your dad and mom were wonderful people, Aunt Tilda said. They seemed to be there for you all the time. But now, being up in heaven, they can be there for everybody.
But they won't be there for me anymore, said Brian sadly, drying his tears. They weren't there for you. I never knew you until now.
Well, that's partly my fault, Brian, Aunt Tilda explained. Even though your dad and I were brother and sister, we were never close, but we still shared our lives together. Aunt Tilda walked over to the dresser. She opened the top drawer and pulled out a photograph album. She and Brian sat down on the floor, and she opened it. See? She asked as Brian turned the pages. There were pictures of Brian and his parents from the time he was born until his last school picture. He slowly closed the book. Now, let's go downstairs and see what Sven has prepared for dinner. I'm starved. Are you? Aunt Tilda asked as they both rose up from the floor.
Brian nodded in agreement and held Aunt Tilda's outstretched hand. They skipped down the hall and both slid down the banister together.
Grandpa, Aunt Tilda allowed you to slide down the banister? Cedric asked. That's pretty cool. I'll say, said Jason excitedly. What other kind of cool stuff were you allowed to do?
All kinds, said Grandfather Brian with love in his voice. Aunt Tilda showed me how to enjoy everything about life. Not a day went by when it wasn't fun.
But weren't you lonely? Inquired Jason. With no one your age to play with?
No, Jason, replied Grandfather Brian. Even though I wasn't lucky enough to have a brother like both of you, I still had people to share my life with. There was Aunt Tilda, of course, Sven, and all of their friends.
Were Aunt Tilda's friends like her? Asked Jason. A little strange?
Some were a little bit strangier, replied Grandfather Brian with a laugh. But they all liked having a good time, and they all wanted to have people to share their times with. What seemed strange to some was normal to them.
Jason and Cedric looked at each other. Jason picked up the toy truck and handed it to Cedric, smiling.
Grandfather Brian looked at both boys and said, "It sure is a nice day outside. Want to race me to the swimming pool and go for a swim?"
You bet, both boys exclaimed in unison. But only if we could slide down the banister first, said Jason.
Well, come on, shouted Grandfather Brian as he ran out of the room.
Jason and Cedric ran quickly after him. The end.
Wow, that was a great story. It was a little sad, and a little funny, and a little happy, and a little everything. Wasn't it, Billy?
Oh, look at that. He's got his face in the popcorn. No, I really do love this story, and it really shows what life is all about. You have tugs, and you have love, so, and love wins in the end.
I'm going to get a t-shirt that says, Tugs and Loves.
Okay.
The movie's starting.
Oh, good. I can't wait.
Billy, look at that. The Birds, starring Birds.
Oh, yeah. He's all eyes right now.
Billy, that was fun, right, Dad?